Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, to the next episode of Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3. I'm your host, ChatterFury333, here to die horribly with Irina Para, my lovely character, and a dragon who, despite the fact that I am right under it and can quite easily, had I enough arrows, had I had the foresight to actually purchase 100 arrows, or a couple hundred arrows when I was back over at Firelink Shrine, would be able to cheese out and kill, but cannot do so for lack of arrows. However, what I can do is cheese out there the fact that there's items here. Oh, come on, a club? That's the exact opposite of what I want. I want a sharp weapon, not a... Okay, whatever. So, we have found out for sure the weapons in front of the dragon are not a claymore. However, what that item is over there, I don't know. And the real question, of course, is what is the dragon going to do now that I'm running over to this place over here, well out of the reach of its fire? Oh, there is a claymore here, and now I'm dead. What I wouldn't give her a homeward bone in this very instance. Why am I trying to heal up normally? Or not normally, I mean, without using a homeward... not a homeward bone. Estus... Ow. Well, I'm dead. I guess we'll find out how the rolling, falling mechanics work, and it is probably percentage-based. Okay, so I was exactly right in the first place and wrong in the second place. And I cannot use the claymore because I do not have the attributes for it yet. So obviously, longsword plus one becomes, for now, the go-to weapon. So that's part of the build already done. And now I want to go back and level up a bit. Now that I know what to level up to, I didn't know what the claymore requirements would be. They're pretty much the same as Dark Souls 1. One extra dexterity. Dark Souls 1 was 16 strength, 12 dexterity. But, yeah, basically the same. So, great. It's not going to be too hard to get. I'm not going to be able to get it, obviously, with one level up at 1,300 souls per level. But I am going to be able to get it soon enough. And, of course, scaling. Oh, that's actually something I want to test, too. Or check. And I want to see if... Is it going to be C and C scaling? Because Dark Souls 1, Claymore scaled with both strength and dexterity equally. Dark Souls 2, you pretty much just went for strength fully. Dex was not useful for scaling. But I don't know. So, D and D. Oh, the longsword scales better with strength than dexterity. That I wasn't aware of. Welcome, host speaker. Hmm. Very well. Then I'm going to need both strength and dexterity at this point. So, I'm going to get myself... Oh, good. Okay. Gives me the R weapon upgrade stuff, so I know how this is going to work. R weapon 2. Okay, you know what? I'm going to probably get dexterity first, because I need both for the claymore. But I need dexterity more urgently for that bow. And I know I said crossbow's part of the build. Bows are allowed, though crossbows are definitely preferred. And I'm probably going to drop the bow once if and when I find a crossbow. But I'm glad I found the claymore exactly where I expected it to be. Although I do feel like that's a bit more of a reference. I think I mentioned before when I saw Andre, I'm not sure if I totally finished my thought, but I was saying I kind of like the fact that Andre is here. I like Andre as a character. I actually don't really like the fact that Andre's here. And to be quite honest, I'm really kind of not sure what to think and a little bit annoyed. I mean, if it's just Andre, that's fine. One callback character, one beloved callback character is fine. If they start bringing back, like, Ziegmeier is out of the question. Ziegmeier's, unless this is in the past, Ziegmeier's long since dead. But if they bring back, like, Solaire, for instance, I don't know how I'd feel. Because Solaire was a good character, but Solaire had their arc. Like, for most people, Solaire died in a cave. Just... Oh yeah, I forgot to get arrows, but whatever. But yeah, for most people, Solaire died in a cave. With a sunlight maggot on his head. Completely delusional and convinced that he had found his son when really he just found a bug. Now, that was kind of a sad bit. But, I mean, the thing is... Oh, these things drop Titanite shards? Okay, mercy's over. I need Titanite shards. I'm sorry, but you guys carry something more valuable than gold in your persons. Oh, no. Anyhow, what I was saying. Oh, right. Yeah, so Solaire had a bad end. Most of the characters in Dark Souls 1 had a pretty bad end. And the only characters that didn't were Shoot, who didn't, really? I guess Frampton Koth are still okay. But yeah, basically, for all the humanoid characters, nothing really went well for them, and it just seems like it'd be weird to have them brought back. Like, a bit of a desperate move. I really would just rather have new characters that are well-written that I can fall in love with all over. I can fall in love with new characters rather than having the same characters and just basically relying on the fact that we fell in love with them already. I would just prefer that they actually have... Hopefully it's just like a handful of characters, or maybe just Andre, because I... But yeah, if it's just Andre, I'm fine with that. If it's more than just Andre, then I'm really not sure what to think. Right, do I train magic doing this? Anyway. So yeah, if it's more than just Andre... I feel like that's almost lazy. That just does not feel like... really the way it should be done. I don't know, I just don't like that idea. Maybe it's just me. I realize a lot of people are just gonna go, oh yay, references, Dark Souls 1, I love that game. And well, it's a good game, yeah, sure. Perfectly reasonable to have loved it. Can't say I exactly fault you for crying out loud. I mean, for one thing, the kick mechanic was definitely a lot more reliable. Oh wait, what am I doing? What am I doing? I know how to... Okay, I don't know why I did that. What I wanted to do was this, then this, then... Ow. Never mind. Then that! Guard break from below! Deserted trousers. Anyhow. Also, as I mentioned before... Oh, I didn't mention before. The other thing I want to do with this character is get a skirt. I know it sounds like a weird thing to look for, but yeah, actually, that's very specifically what I want to get. How'd I get so many more souls? This must be much more oh, right, because I killed all the idle enemies for just... for extra Titanite shards. That's right. Okay, so, anyway, as I was saying, I do want a skirt, too. Just, like, legging skirt. Hopefully something like that. I really liked the dingy skirt from 1. Although I did find... yeah, that was probably the best one I found for this sort of thing. Anyway, what am I looking at for health? Okay, my health is not very good. And I do not have enough for heal... Go back to regen mode. Then run! I want to know what's past this thing. Alright, so yeah, as... So, skirt, and also I don't want more Dark Souls 1 references, if at all possible, because frankly... Make something new. Give me something new to fall in love with, don't make me... Oh, shoot. Don't rely on references, that just seems lazy to me. Also, another thing I noticed is that the souls fly towards me when the enemies die, which is very much like Dark Souls 2, so I expect at some point there's going to be some enemy or something like the golems, which will take advantage of that, and that'll be a thing where you basically go, oh, hey, this is a soul-powered enemy. Wow, okay, that was more than I expected. Like, outstanding Dark Souls 1 mimic, not the... it's exactly the Dark Souls 1 mimic. I mean, I expected the mimic, obviously, that's why I attacked him in the first place. It's just... seriously, the first chest in the game? The first chest in the game is a mimic. This is a game designed for people who played the earlier games. For sure. That's the... Whoa! Okay, I gotta... That was terribly unsafe. I can get back to those souls no problem, but yeah. Oh, shoot! Do I have any Lloyd's Talismans? I was going to check that, but, you know, I was kind of in the middle of a fight. Do I have... No, I do not have Lloyd's Talisman. I cannot trivially get rid of that mimic. Shoot. But yeah, first chest in the game is a mimic. Okay, so... Does that make a difference? Is that... No, that hollow is still coming at me. That hollow's still dead. Oops. So are you. So yeah. This game is a game meant for veterans. Just putting that out there. So if you haven't played Dark Souls 1, play Dark Souls 1 and then come and play this, because this game was not meant for people who haven't yet played Dark Souls 1. Dark Souls 2 didn't feel like it was meant for people who had played Dark Souls 1. It felt like it was meant for people who hadn't, honestly, because it wasn't... There were some connections between the two, but honestly, you could play either one in either order, and you wouldn't spoil the other. Like, if you paid really close attention to the lore, you might get some hints that help you figure out sort of how things might go in two. Oh, sorry, in one, if you hadn't played one already. But in all honesty, no, there wasn't a huge amount of connection. This one, on the other hand, if you haven't played a Dark Souls game yet, you're in for a lot of rude awakenings. Like, ruder than they would be if you hadn't already played the game. That mimic being a really good example of that, where it's like, I know about it because I know to look for mimics. And also, I did notice the chain was not connected to the ground, which is the hint for mimics. Well, the Dark Souls 1 hint for mimics. Dark Souls 2, I think, had a different hint set for mimics, because it also had the steel chests were also mimicked, potentially, which is not true of Dark Souls 1. Dark Souls 1 steel chests could not be mimics, wooden chests only. Not sure of 3. Not sure if 3 is going to do it, which way 3 is going to do it. Oh, I didn't repost. Oh, whatever. You die. See, healing over time... Whoa, okay. I was like, healing over time seems to require a lot less MP than the heal spell requires. Okay, you're not breathing fire, so I can run! Run for the mimic! And whatever's on this corpse, deserted trousers, which I hadn't actually looked up. What do deserted trousers do compared to what I currently have? They're heavier, they have a bit more armor to them. I'm at 55% equip load ratio, what the heck? How heavy are claymores? 9 pounds? Okay, they are heavier than they used to be. Oh yeah. Huh. I'll take off the bow then. 50 is not a huge limit, but I do kind of want to stay below it. Actually, you know what? For the time being, I'll take off the claymore and I'll put on the bow because the bow might have some occasional use, but that claymore is not going to get used until I have the stats for it. It's just not. But yeah, I mean, really, like, I know to look for mimics. Most people won't. Oops. And even if you do, it's like... Oh crap, gotta get away, it's gonna try to eat me. Okay. That's the try to eat you attack. The hug. Oh nice, they fixed the hitbox issue from Dark Souls 2. Good. Dark Souls 2 had a horrible issue where if someone tried to do a grab attack on you to eat you, they would usually hit for the simple reason that they had no easy way to miss. Like, basically, your hitbox would stay where you were briefly, and it was really annoying. On top of the input lag issue. Seriously? Well, what has this got? So it's dark. Standard axe. Weight can be used to inflict heavy damage, but must be used carefully as it leaves its wielder open to retaliation. Despite the fact that I can wear it, I don't care. We're swords, despite the start in... I realize I started with strength. That's what clerics do, but... Early miracles are helpful, but also it's just I wanted miracles the first time around. And this is a remake of a character. That was a remake of a character. Yeah, I'll do something more original for a second playthrough. I'm assuming... I mean, I have no reason not to do a second playthrough at this point. So I'm kind of assuming at this point that I'm going to want to do a second playthrough. And it's a knight of some description. Okay. I see you are a knight of some description. I see you have a sword run through your gut of some description. Though admittedly, the description of your gut is going to be a lot more vague than it used to be thanks to my having put a sword through it. Lothric Knight Shield. Not that I plan to wear it, but... What does it say? Shield of the renowned Lothric Knights, decorated with a royal crest. The Lothric Knights contended with dragons, and their shields have suitably high lightning absorption, befitting a dragon slayer's arms. Which doesn't make any sense to me, since lightning is the weakness of dragons, not... Well, okay, admittedly, it might be like the Valley of Drake's Drakes, which did breathe lightning, but lightning is the weakness of dragons. So, what? Are they just gonna retcon dragons every single game in this series, or what? Anyhow. That was relatively easy. I realize every single time I say that, it's gonna be making a mockery of somebody who had a really hard time with part of the game that I'm finding, well, relatively easy. There's a thief down there. There's another one. I can't see it. I just know there is. I'm just sure I'm missing one. I don't want to jump down there. Although, now the other one's got to be out here then. No, no one directly out here. Okay. So, do you not have friends? Looks like I was right. I was right. There is a second one. Paranoia paid off. As did a long weapon because it makes rolling attacks a lot more reliable. Okay. It's just, it's a sense you get after a little while, you know? Like, oh, hey, there's a thing. It looks like it's, oops. It looks like it's there trying to, you know, bait me out a little bit, make me think, oh, yeah, I can deal with this. Make me overconfident. If any time Dark Souls 3 makes you feel like something's going to be easy or something is just going to give itself to you, that's when something's going to try to kill you. It's going to try hard, and you got to be careful and you got to be smart in those situations, because those are the situations Dark Souls is designed to trap you in. Is there anything in here? Other than a bunch of wood splinters in my body now? I mean, seriously. Does not do wonders for the face. Well, granted, not exactly embered up or anything. Was that a gunpowder barrel? Well, anyhow. Yeah, that's a thing that Dark Souls 2 does. Or Dark Souls in general. Dark Souls as a series does that. What it also does is make you feel like, should I go back and level up because I need levels in order to get at my Claymore? The answer is usually, are you feeling lucky? And right now, I'm not totally sure. Oh. Attentive? No. Lucky? Maybe. But clearly not observant, or sufficiently observant. And you are potential sources of Titanite chunks, therefore you die for my farming purposes. Because I am a cruel man. Okay, so one other thing I do have spoiled is that there is a zombie up there that is, in fact, one of those goo monsters. Another one. So, I don't think that's the path forward. It's a path I want to take at some point. I didn't open a shortcut, though. I thought I did at some point. Oh, right, I thought I had, and I ended up meeting that knight. And that knight turned out to be not part of a shortcut, but also not much of a challenge. And then he had the three assassins or thieves or whatever. Three thieves, I guess. And those thieves were a bit more of a challenge because Dark Souls 3 was trying to trick me, as is wont to do. And I have another bonfire, which is why it's generally a good idea to go up. Or at least in this case, it was a good idea to go up, because now I don't have to make a choice. I just go back to Firelink Shrine and get my levels. Well, I'm liking this area so far. I mean, as a Dark Souls veteran, it seems great. For someone who has not played Dark Souls before? Okay, first tip, pay attention. Now that mimic is kind of cheap. I think that mimic, having that first one there, like, see, the thing about mimics in Dark Souls 1, they're introduced in Sen's Fortress. Welcome. And in Sen's Fortress, you basically have, by that point, that's mid-game. That's the middle of the game. And every chest you've met seen up to that point has been a chest which was level, it was aligned to the wall, and you had no hard time really telling, oh, this is a chest, which was fine. But the problem is, in Dark Souls, okay, so I have enough dexterity for the Claymore. How much strength scaling does it do, though? Okay, so it scales more with strength, but it's not much. Especially given that this gets me closer to using a bow, and also, it works anyway. Anyhow, with Dark Souls One, you basically had an idea of this is a chest. This is the sort of thing a chest is. This is how we have chests. They're aligned to the walls. They have their, if you're really paying attention, they have their chain hooked to the ground. And they all look like they're pretty well aligned. Like they're very carefully placed. They aren't just haphazardly thrown anywhere. They are carefully placed. In Dark Souls 3, however, the first chest you find is a mimic. That's aligned to the wall, actually. It does have the chain disconnected from the ground, but it's aligned to the wall. So you don't really have that hint that, oh, hey, by the way, this chest is a little bit suspect, don't you think? Maybe you should look a little more closely into it. Actually, that for that matter, do you have any Lois talismans? No. Great. Not what I was hoping for. Anyhow, yeah, so first chest you encounter is a mimic? That seems a little, like, as a veteran, that makes sense. I attacked it because I thought, who knows, maybe the first chest in the game is a mimic, which it is. Okay. Or one of the first chests. You certainly don't have half the game to get used to chests as chests before you realize, hey, something's a bit askew with this chest here, which turns out to be a mimic. So you think, okay, well, chests that are a little askew, I've got to be careful of, which you do. In this game, at this point, all chests are suspect. For a veteran, not a problem. For a newcomer, that's a problem. So I don't totally agree with that design decision. Even though I did kind of benefit from it from just a player perspective, I suppose. There was another thing I was going to say. Oh, right. Yeah, the other thing that came to mind was Snuggly. Or Sparkly, or Dina and Tilo. The crows, the traitors, the... Basically, every single Dark Souls game, you have some NPC you can trade stuff with. Actually, come to think of it, one thing I did want to check. I have 6 Souls of a Deserted Corpse. No, come to think of it, I could get that bow level right now. Sorry, a bit of a back and forth here. Good thing the loading times are low. But yeah, I'm curious if there is a traitor crow. There usually is. I don't know if Bloodborne had one, but every other Dark Souls, Demon Souls, and all the other Dark Souls games have had one, so I expect Dark Souls 3 will have one too, and I don't know where it is. Oh, wait, I needed to... I'm getting backwards here. All right, yeah. Thank you. Okay, so... How much are Fading Souls? 50, okay, I called that one. Which means we're probably dealing with a situation where it's like 50 and then 100. I'm just going to use all of them, because... Guessing it's 100, let's see, it's 200 each. Okay, so the one I got first must be like 1,000. Or 800, possibly. Hard to say, I don't have everything along the way, but now we have enough for that bow. And given that we have enough for that bow, even though it's not a crossbow, at this point I kind of have to make do. So, give me some arrows, or sell me arrows, I suppose. A nice round 50. Did I buy some bolts? I think I did. I don't really care at the moment, because crossbow will... Oh, I did buy some bolts. I bought plenty of bolts. Okay. So we're good for arrows and we're good for bolts. Now, back to Tower on the Wall and dealing with that goo monster. And I do realize I left a path behind. The upper path, one of the areas I got killed from the first bonfire... Actually, you know what? I'm going to deal with that first. I'll leave the goo zombie to the next episode. But we will be done with the travel here. Travel and load times are basically done. And yeah, I know, fast travel is a thing. I understand it's not... I do kind of wish that fast travel was locked off, but it's a thing. It exists. Hopefully it doesn't break the shortcut-oriented design, but... Well, we'll see. Alright, source of chunks. Or shards, not chunks. Far from chunks. Nowhere near the chunk level. Would you shut up? Okay, and you are just... These are all pretty trivial to kill. It's like, it's actually kind of weird, because these enemies are relatively trivial to kill, but then you have things like the mimics, which are a problem, and then I guess you have sort of the beef gate enemies, like that one enemy at the very start in Firelink Shrine that I still... I might be able to kill now, just for having a slightly stronger weapon. And having a bit more experience with the game and its general engine. But yeah, I don't know. Anyhow, This is where I wanted to go. Because here, there's... Okay, so... Screamer dude... sounds the alarm, who is going to die a horrible, horrible death before they get to sound the alarm. They had... Oh, I see how that works. So they have friends. Their friends are currently kind of not wanting to really acknowledge the world exists, so I will just deal with the ones that do currently actually have... that are currently not in a catatonic state. Actually... Oh, wait. Oops. I thought I was two-handing. I mean, it's still good to have that... Oh, wait. That's not the health... Oh, I see it. The health region must go away once I use an Estus Flask or similar healing item. All right. What's up here? Binoculars! Oh, okay. So binoculars exist. Which, I mean, I guess is kind of makes sense given that I mentioned earlier in my mechanics test that the whole binocular mechanic was essentially it aims your character. Actually, I could... Can I... What? Switch. Yes, add binoculars. So here's how binoculars work. I point to an area. Oops. And then I swing it. That was not what I wanted to do. Point to an area. Like, it doesn't matter where I point to. My character will now be facing that direction. The camera will be facing the correct direction. So I point to an area. Get out of binoculars mode. And if I were to fire like this without binoculars, which is actually how you did the binocular trick in Dark Souls 1, it would fire at the castle in the skybox. Now, the neat thing about that is that a castle in the skybox is... Wow, that alert is a real problem. Anyway, that castle in the skybox, although admittedly you can kind of see it coming if you're paying attention, so I'll give that to paying attention, sneak behind it. Doesn't seem like it's actually that good at hearing, so it all works out. But yeah, what was I saying? Oh, right, yeah, so with the binoculars, you do that. But, like I said before, because the aiming works pretty freely, binoculars work. In Dark Souls 2, that wouldn't have worked. Binoculars don't work in Dark Souls 2. They do in Dark Souls 1. Which, of course, raises the question. I mean, granted, it means that it works for spells. If I had any arranged spells, if I had Lightning Spear. But the second question is, does it work for crossbows? Is it required for crossbows? Also, it occurs to me that from here... Okay, so I see how this is supposed to go. Well, possibly. There is the possibility that it's not actually what I think it is. See, what I think it is right now is this dragon's out here, and I have a clear shot to this dragon because I'm supposed to. Now, if you remember, I mentioned that in Dark Souls 1, you basically never had a clear shot to the dragon to actually shoot at it. However, if you could get shots in... Oh. Maybe I'm wrong. But yeah, if you could get shots in, they had a second mechanic, which was the dragon would come after you. Like, the dragon would lift off of its perch and come after you and basically go, screw you, Hollow, just randomly in the corner, pegging me out with shots. I'm not going to stand for that. Now, granted, I'm not exactly in a position where I can exploit that whole thing, and quite frankly, I'm barely dealing enough damage to really qualify as any sort of damage at all, so I'm going to have to go to the area where I was hitting him before. But anyway, the point is, it seems like they're actually trying to give you at least some vague sense of hope that you can kill the dragon, even though clearly you cannot, rather than making it seem like, no, you absolutely cannot kill the dragon, and then, well, you can, but it's really hard, and making sure that if you try to exploit it, anything you could think of to exploit it with, the developers already thought of that and don't let you do it. Oh, right. This is the area that goes to the area that's the other bonfire. This... How do you get to this? Oh, wait. So, hang on. I noticed there was a drop-off. I guess that's how you get to it? That seemed like suicide. I don't think that's the way you get to that. But anyway, we'll have to find out... Oh, mouse. Let this last a little bit longer. Because we're at the end of the episode, but we will find out in a sec. Oh, well, I guess I could jump down. Heal! Rather than regen, although I suppose static regen is still a better option if I'm not under direct threat. Gold pine resin. Hey, lightning damage. All right, so that's the end of this episode. Thank you for watching, and I will have more upcoming, as always, so stay tuned for the next one. And until then, have a good night, everyone.